Hikari Taiko, with our sacred call to gather. Thank you so, so much. We are going to hear more from them. Ladies and gentlemen, hi, Crestone. Hi. How are you doing tonight? Are you ready? Well, okay, let's ask the clouds. Are you ready to part? Come on, give us a break, clouds, everybody. Whatever we get, we're going to get, right? And we're going to enjoy it. We're going to be here in this moment, present together. Thank you so much for coming out to the start, this kickoff, this celebration of this dark skies community. Crestone, my name is Michael Tiernan, by the way. I'm sort of a new guy in town, and I am very, very honored to be able to MC this evening. This is a full circle moment for me because 23 years ago, I was doing a 30-day silent retreat at the Nada Retreat Center just over here. And I thought I was going to be a priest, right? I thought I was going to be a Catholic priest. And I got into the silence, and I got into the beauty of this place, and then I saw the stars. And the songs started flowing out of me. I started writing songs like nobody's business. And I discovered, after a long time, took a while, but I was actually an artist. And so now I'm a singer-songwriter. Didn't become a priest, but it took me a while to figure that out. And I owe a lot of that to this very town and to this very sky. Hi. You all looking good tonight, by the way. Give yourselves a hand. Come on. So we have been called. The drums have called us. Taiko is a prayer. It's a sacred gathering. And after this past year, what a gift it is to be able to be side by side, to be sharing this space together, right? You guys haven't had anything for over a year, right? So in just a moment, as it gets darker, and I know you all are used to it, but I'm from San Diego, and I still am not used to that shock when the stars come out. It literally just punches me in the gut sometimes with its beauty. So in a while, that sky will explode with that canopy of stars and this ever-present art canvas above our heads that both grounds us, and it keeps us looking heavenward, keeps us hoping, keeps us dreaming, keeps us expanding. Crestone, we have so much to celebrate this evening. Now, as we gather to experience the night as a kickoff to our Loving Our Skies, our Dark Skies Festival, we're in for a treat this evening, my friends, with song and story, and culminating in a tour of the night sky by someone who's dedicated his whole life to studying these blessed cosmos. And so as we begin this journey to reverence the night sky together, it gives me great honor to introduce to you someone who's been really a tireless and an enthusiastic advocate for protecting our connection to these dark skies. She's helped lead the charge with your help in the application to become an official Dark Skies community. It's been a long and it's been a very worthwhile process. And that leads us here tonight. Thank you so much for being here. Excuse this gratuitous astronomy use of terms, but in my book, this woman is a supernova of energy. She has been a North Star to this town for years, a guiding light, and has helped corral and organize Crestone into a constellation of quite some beauty. And I'm honored I get to call you my friend. Crestone, your mayor, Kairina Danforth. Let's welcome her up.
So the good news is that I don't have a written down speech, not even a sentence. But the much better news is that today, the International Dark Sky Association at 8 o'clock this morning put something on its website, sent it at the same time to every social media all around the world, right now, you can look in your computer and find it on Twitter, on Instagram. It's gone to the Denver Post. And it's my privilege to be able to tell you that Crestone, Colorado has been named an International Dark Sky Community, effective 8 o'clock this morning. So I'm not going to read much of it. I'm just going to read a little bit that I think is interesting. It's all interesting. You can read it all. But it says, in recognition of its exceptional dedication to the preservation of the night sky through the implementation and enforcement of quality lighting policies, dark sky education, citizen support, the International Dark Sky Association announced today that it has designated the town of Crestone, Colorado, USA, as an international dark sky community. The town is only the 31st designated international community worldwide and the 4th in Colorado. I want to read about one more paragraph. Crestone is the world's first international dark sky community to acknowledge the rights of nature. Its deep commitment to the environment is evident from the 2018 adoption of its pioneering Rights of Nature resolution, which states that the town officially recognizes that nature, natural ecosystems, communities, and all species possess intrinsic and inalienable rights, which must be effectuated to protect life on Earth. The resolution also acknowledges the deep spiritual connection between residents of Crestone and the natural world and embraces the community's role as a steward of nature. So this is not about only the town of Crestone. It's about the Crestone community. We're a unique community. I think we're kind of proud of being a unique community. And here tonight, we have assembled what we're hoping will be a unique opportunity for you to experience the night and reverence the celestial wonders that we're going to see above us. The performers you see tonight have worked tirelessly for many hours to present something that we're hoping you're all going to like. So not only are we, I want to acknowledge the Board of Trustees of the town of Crestone. They have been very supportive of this all through the last several years, and they've formed a committee, a dark sky committee that has been very helpful. And also we have a dedicated town staff. But we're also a community of volunteers, and kind of like the old music festival, we've had volunteers these past few works working tirelessly, countless hours. I don't think they counted the hours. And so that's part of tonight and also tomorrow. And we're also a community that not only loves our dark sky, but we are committed to preserving it. And we're a community that is unique. We're a creative community. We're a wonderful community. And I like to think of us as a place of the heart. So there's just one more thing. When I was a little girl, which was a few years ago, I remember saying something when the stars came out at night. And I'm hoping that some of you right here, right now, remember this. It starts out like this: starlight, star bright. A show of hands, how many of you have ever heard that? I'm going to ask you to say that. We're going to say that together. And at the end, I ask that you make a commitment that a prayer, a wish that the world can be more conscious of taking care of the rights of acknowledging the rights of nature, and that we think that artificial light pollution should be protected equally with the water and the wildlife and the air. So here we go. It's pretty simple. If you don't know it, I think I see a lot of hands. So if we could all say this together. Starlight, star bright, I wish I may, I wish I might, have the wish I wish tonight. Thank you, dear friends.
Thank you so much, Kairina. Amazing. And ladies and gentlemen, as we prepare the stage once again for Hikari Taiko from the Shumei Center right up the road, and I'm sure most of you, many of you are familiar with that amazing community that brings such beauty and art, especially tonight. And that's actually one of the three pillars of their philosophy, is the appreciation of beauty and art. So I know we didn't get enough of that at the beginning, so there's more. And we're gonna just enjoy this next performance as they get set up. From the Shumei Center, Hikari Taiko, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. That first selection, ladies and gentlemen, is a song called Hitotsu, which means one. As friends living on the same earth, it is a miracle to be able to all witness and drink in the same night sky together. As they prepare for their second song, which is called Shobayashi, is a song made with the image of young people flapping their wings toward their future hopes. Hikari Taiko will perform with hopes and prayers for world peace, making all of our hearts into one. And a little bit behind their name, ladies and gentlemen, Shumei Crestone's Hikari Taiko group. The word Hikari, he, is the sun which represents heaven. Ka is the harmonizing force that unites heaven and earth. Ri is Crestone, which represents the earth. Hikari from the Shumei Center. And also, I might add, they are celebrating their 19th anniversary this very weekend at their Crestone facility. They so deserve a round of applause for that. And we so thank them for being here in the midst of such a busy weekend to share this night sky with us. As they prepare for their second piece. Thank you, Taiko. That was incredible. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time from the Shumei Center, Hikari Taiko, thank you so much for blessing us with that reverent and prayerful session. Thank you so much. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to turn the stage here a little bit as we strike and get ready for our next presenters. And just want to remind also everybody, if they didn't see at the welcome table, we have plenty of great materials to hand out tonight describing just what this designation is and amazing just information about light pollution and what we can do. So please make sure you grab that if you haven't yet. Plenty of great information out there. And also just a bit of housekeeping as well. The restrooms are up at the conference center, which is straight up past the table there on the left. And as they strike, we'll be right back with our next act, everybody. We'll be back in 2 minutes. Cheers. All righty, ladies and gentlemen, we are set. If we can call your attention back to the stage, we would love to invite up a very special group of ladies who hasn't sung together in this whole year, so we are so excited to bring them up. And ladies, you can feel free to come on up behind me as I introduce you. So far, we have been called by the drums to be present and aware of this beautiful space that we share. Now it's our turn to call back to the stars. So it gives me great pleasure to introduce these amazing women coming up behind me. Crestone's very own female choral group, the Songbirds, led by Jillian over here. Oh, yes, who will be leading us in calling the stars. So they formed, I am told, around 2016, is that right? Around the kind of the presidential election times in a atmosphere of negativity towards women and nature. That's why they started to use their voice together. And because of the pandemic, they haven't even sung together for a year. The Songbirds dedicate their songs to the honoring of Mother Earth and the divine feminine that lives in all beings. They offer their songs tonight to raise the vibrational frequency for our community and the planet, and to heal what needs healing, and to bring a sense of joy in a time when things around us are pretty dang intense. They are delighted to share a few songs at this dark night celebration, and they are inviting us all to join in singing the songs, and the words are on your program. No, they're not. Okay, that was an old draft. This is Crestone, roll with it, baby. Jillian! Songbirds, take us to flight.
Hello? Whoa. We are truly delighted to be here, and I wanted to also introduce Rich Jewett, who is accompanying us on the guitar. Yay, Rich. Before we start singing, I would like to turn the mic over to Pamela Ramadeh, who has a few words to share from all of us.
Thank you, Jillian, and thank you for founding the Songbirds. And I first of all want to thank and all acknowledge all of you who have come out tonight. It's a pretty spectacular moment in a very international way. There are communities far less blessed than we are to have these dark skies to honor and also to have the isolation and the safety. There's a, I'm not remembering the author of the lyrics, but that notion of the bright, sacred, wait a minute, the bright, blessed days and the dark, sacred nights. And it's something that I'm so reminded of by living here. And I also want to acknowledge all of those who are continuing to take precautions to say, keep each other and ourselves safe. The only songbirds that are here on the stage this evening are those who have been able to be vaccinated. And you might be able to tell that we're a little more senior than many of you. So I want you to please reach out, communicate with your neighbors. Understand that we all have a lot of differences in views, health needs, even prayer needs and spiritual understandings and needs. So continue to be in communication and respect with one another on our differing choices on what staying safe and keeping one another safe It's my wish and prayer that from this pandemic, we all learn that we are indefinitely and forever interrelated, and may our interrelatedness make us stronger and better. Thank you very much, and enjoy the music. The last song we're going to sing, you might know. If you do, please sing out, and also know that part of the reason that we as singers have brought up this message about spreading, when we sing, we spew more. So if you're going to sing out, do it maybe in enough space you're not spewing on anybody. So enjoy, and thank you for listening.
So we want to share, the first song we want to share is a Russian folk song, and it's pretty repetitive, so if you start getting the hang, or when you start getting the hang of it, please do join in, and it becomes a round after the third time we sing the verse, so yeah, have fun with us. Thanks. So the next song we'd like to do is has been adapted for this particular event from Irving Berlin's Blue Skies, and you may be most familiar with It's being sung by Willie Nelson. And this adaptation was created by our very own Sharon Corcoran. Yay! So I'm not sure how many of you remember the movie Pinocchio. Anyway, this is a song that you may remember from it or have heard. When You Wish Upon a Star. I always feel like Tinkerbell is floating around when I sing this song.
If your heart is
It's only a year.
That was the solo.
Okay.
Crestone, Songbirds, ladies and gentlemen, come on, let's let them hear your love. As this night deepens, check out that sliver of the moon right above us. I think we have the telescopes pointing over there. So far, that's, there's going to be more stuff popping out here soon, but I know what that is. That's the moon. Professor Burns, am I right in my assessment? That is the moon. Okay, good. All righty, well, we are going to do a set change here for our next presentation. That is a beautiful looking gong, Mr. Patrick. That is amazing. All right. Give us just a few moments to switch on over and we'll be right back. All righty, well, we are going to do a set change. Just a few moments to switch on and over, and we'll be right back.
The right one.
All right, the space station is passing over. I've just been informed. So now we have two things, the moon and the space station. We'll be in business here soon. Oh, yes. Thanks for that, for pointing that out, sir. Appreciate it. Good morning. Just making sure you're still awake. Well, look at you. We're already ready to go. I was going to sing him a song, but you were so quick to set up. Ladies and gentlemen, look behind me here, this amazing, amazing art piece. And we're about to hear the story of how this came to be. This was submitted as part of the Dark Skies application. And there's a story behind it. And I cannot wait. I've heard just a little bit. I've heard the short version. And I am ready to hear from our next guest, ladies and gentlemen, with a special story about his connection to the stars, how this painting came to be, and a gong presentation. Mr. Patrick Moore, everybody.
From the dawn of time, our species has had a special relationship with the stars. Our ancient ancestors gazed upon the pristine dark skies and saw these bright shining objects. They saw them as beings of light from a distant realm. They saw them as guides and guardians and oracles. Our ancestors were able to spread across the lands because they followed guide stars from horizon to horizon with confidence that if they needed to or wanted to, that same star would arise in the same place the next night and they could go home. They saw the stars as guardians because before our ancestors knew about seasons, other stars rose when the weather was about to change and turn cold. It allowed our ancestors to prepare for that. They also saw the stars as oracles because before they could tell, other stars would rise, foretelling the arrival of the herds, which sustained our ancestors and began the hunt. You may know of the some of the earliest art, our cave paintings in Spain and France and Turkey. And they depict our ancestors on a hunt, hunting herds. But recently, scientists have discovered that they also depict the position of the stars that foretell the arrival of the herds. They were the first star charts. But long before all of this, our close and intimate relationship with the stars began. You see, almost every element and chemical in our body was formed in stars. We are the children of those stars. Yes. The first stars used helium and hydrogen, and over billions of years, they fused the nuclei of those together to form heavier elements like carbon, magnesium, and many, many other trace elements on the periodic table. And then after billions of years, those stars exploded in supernova. That's called the first generation star. And they exploded around here in our vicinity. And then after a while, another star formed in the stellar nursery that was created by that supernova. And those are called second generation stars, and they fuse the carbon, the other trace elements, and the helium and the hydrogen together to form even heavier elements, such as nickel and iron and gold. And over billions of years, they did that. They fused those elements together. And then they blew up in a supernova, boom, right around here, right where we live. And then eventually another star formed. And that is believed to be our star, our sun. And we know that because of the spectral analysis of it tells us that it's burning not just helium and hydrogen, but nickel and iron and carbon and gold. And we also know it because our planet contains all of those. And because we contain all of those. We would not exist if those stars had not created those elements for us. That's amazing. Can you dig it? Okay. So I believe that when those stars were forming these elements, we retained the resonance of the star at the time it was forming them. And I believe that we have that resonance within us. Just as the rocks on Earth retain the magnetic code of when they were formed on this planet, what the magnetic field was like. Okay? I have a special relationship with the resonance of the stars. Let me tell you a story when I was a small child. And I invite you to close your eyes and relive this with me. When I was little, my family and I lived in far west Texas in Odessa. And when I was three, my mother was taking me for a pre-bedtime nighttime walk. And she was holding my hand. And we were walking in silence. And close your eyes and live this. Close your eyes and live this. And I stopped holding my mother's hand. I stopped while still holding my mother's hand. And she stopped with me. And I stopped because I heard something. And I wanted to know what I heard. I didn't know what that was. I didn't know where it was coming from. So I listened some more. And I listened more. This is what I heard. Thank you. And then I looked up at my mother, who was looking down at me patiently. And I said, "Mommy, I can't wait to go back and sing with the stars." That little child had remembered the resonance of the place it was born. And we can still do that. It resonates with us. So, years later, about 3 years ago, I was inspired to paint this painting in remembrance of that event, because it stayed with me my whole life. Those circles are not planets. They're the stars resonating to that little child in the lower left. I brought it to Crestone. I put it in a Crestone setting rather than an Odessa, Texas setting, because artists can do that kind of stuff. And this is my home. And so when I was asked to create a motto and a logo for the International Dark Sky Association application, I remembered this and this and the fact that every element in our body comes from one. And I put it together. And that's how we became internationally known as the Children of the Stars. It is so important that we protect the night sky, the dark, pristine night sky. Just as our ancestors were inspired so long ago, the stars remind us that our location and our connection is far greater and far more magical than we sometimes perceive. The stars call us every night to be awesome, like they are, for we are their children. Thank you.
Artist Patrick Moore, everybody. Amazing, my friend. Amazing. And part of that story, you just came across like this YouTube of this guy playing this gong, right? Yeah. And like a minute and a half in, you're like, oh my God, that's what it sounds like.
To go, and I was just listening to him play, and he played a sound that was exactly like what I had heard as a child from the skies. So that's the stars singing. By the way, this painting is entitled Singing with the Stars. Thank you.
Patrick, thank you so much. Let's give one more round of applause, everybody. All right, quick little stage changeover. There's so much more amazing presentations to come, especially as the sky darkens up even more. We're gonna get an amazing tour of our dark skies here. And I notice everybody's pointing out different. I think I saw Polaris out there. We're gonna turn off these lights pretty soon too, so that we can let our eyes adjust. All right, we're gonna turn up a little bit of music. We're gonna get ready for some live music. Benjamin, hit that music over there. We'll turn this stage. We'll be right back in just a couple moments, folks. An amazing tour of our dark skies here. And I notice everybody's pointing out different. I think I saw Polaris out there. We're gonna turn off these lights pretty soon too, so that we can let our eyes adjust. All right, we're going to turn up a little bit of music. We're going to get ready for some live music. Benjamin, get that music over there. We'll turn this stage. We'll be in just a couple moments, folks. Thank you. Check. Ah, here we are. Thank you for your patience as we do our set changes. Benji, if you can bring me up on one and put Jeffy on in three. Ah, sweet music to accompany these stars coming out. Patrick's story and the songbirds and the calling from Taiko. Like I said at the beginning, this is kind of a full circle night for me. Having written some songs that were just pouring out of me at a time when I was doing other stuff, I was like getting ready to be a priest, and all of a sudden all these just songs started coming out of me. And discovering I was an artist. And every time I could, I would get back out to Crestone and just sit in that silence and sit in that space. And one night I was on tour and I did a festival a little bit north of here, and I came down for a 3-day writing retreat. And I sat out on the roof of my hermitage. And as that canopy of stars exploded above me, I had this melody going through my head. There was no words, it was just a melody. Bed a little bit later, and I fell asleep, and I woke up, and there were the words. That which made all this, come give me a kiss. That which shoots these stars, come show me.
To open my hand.
to let go of my now. That song was inspired by these Crestone skies. Ah, I've written so many songs here. And one time I was coming here for a songwriting retreat, just a personal thing. And I was missing my lady at home. And I was passing through Poncha Springs and coming out over the valley. And it was September, and the aspens were just alive and bright and on fire. And I was just thinking, man, I wish Tracy was here with me to see this. And then I came down and rolled along the Sanguinary Christos, and I just kept thinking, man, I want to share this with her. I want to share this experience with her, and this peace that I feel, and this creativity that kind of just happens when I get here. And I'm so excited that we recently, after so many years of me talking about it and us just coming out for little visits, that we finally landed in a little nest right down the street. So we're sort of your new neighbors. So it's so good to be here. And this is a song that I'd written when I landed in Crestone, and I was thinking of her that several years ago and kind of dreaming of our future. And this song is called Same Sky, and it's about just being united. You know, one of the things about the sky is that you look up and it just makes you humble, right? You feel so small. You just are just overwhelmed by the magnitude of the greatness of the universe and the cosmos. And it makes you feel small, but at the same time, it lifts you up, right? It affirms you. It makes you feel connected, knowing that beauty that you see, that there must be some beauty in you to be able to perceive that beauty, right? And that we're connected. And I was looking up at that same sky, and I got here in a Crestone, and I was thinking about Tracy, and I was looking up at the sky, and she sent me this text, and she said, hey, I'm at the beach, I'm looking up at the sky, and I'm thinking of you. And that's where this song came from. There's only so much sunshine left in the day. I wanna bottle it up and send it your way. Oh yeah. So you could see what I'm seeing. Cause I spent it for the morning caught in the days, just trying to burn away the mist and the haze of my empty feeling. Come on. All the leaves are turning this time of year. The only thing that's missing is for you to be here, so you can see what I'm seeing, yeah. Cause it's a guilty, guilty feeling to be taken by all this beauty when you're not by my side. Can't you know what I'm thinking? I'll send it into the blue, yeah, ah, yeah.
into this room. Oh, 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 because there's all this space and all this time between us and they. Well, I know, well, that somewhere we're looking up at the same sky. Yeah, yeah. Looking up at the same sky. Yeah, yeah. Oh, no. You were on the beach, it was on a mountain. We were looking at the stars, we were drinking from the same fountain. You're pouring out of the same night. But the need to be alone is like medicine, so I can fill you up when I get home again. Hey, don't you know what I'm thinking? I'll send it into the blue. Ah, yeah. Into this blue. Oh, yeah. Come on. Because there's all of this space and all this time between us and they. Well, I know, well, that somewhere you're looking up at the same sky. Yeah, yeah. You're looking up at the same sky. Yeah, yeah. So much sunshine left in the day. I wanna bottle it up and send it your way. Whoa. So you can see what I'm seeing.
Hey, by the way, this is my good friend Mr. Jeffrey Stasny, also from San Diego, California. And this, you know, in a Crestone synchronistic way, my good friend Jeffrey here was sent out on business to New Mexico this last week. And said, hey, I think I can make it up for the Dark Skies Festival. And here he is, my San Diego brother. Get to play some percussion with me. Oh, yes. Thank you for being here, Jeffy. Thanks for making the trip and experiencing this with us tonight. All righty, so in my haste for getting ready for this evening, you guys have seen I've been kind of like running around like a chicken with my head cut off. I know, I realize. And I had written a song for tonight. And the song was written based on Patrick's story, because I was so touched by Patrick's story of how when he was 3 years old, he heard that above his head and he looked up and he heard that vibration, that emanation. And I'd written this song, and guess what? I forgot to put it on my little iPad here. So what's gonna happen? I'm gonna play that song at the end of the night, at the end of the presentation, because I have it on my computer in my car over there. And so during Shane's presentation, I'm gonna go grab it, and we're gonna end off the night with that song, all right? So I was up here going, oh my gosh, I wrote this song just for tonight, and I don't have it. So we're gonna do it at the end of the night. But right now, what I want you to do, okay, now, were you wondering, like, back at the booth, they're like, why are they giving me lighters? What's going on here? Well, we have been called by these stars. We have called back to them. And during this next song, I want everybody to take those out. We're going to shine our lights, all right, to the heavens, all right? So that was the idea of that we have this amazing light inside of us, that we can also receive light, but we can also give it. And as a metaphor to that, we're going to do that during this song. You guys get those things ready? Without, you know, I know my son, he's 11, and anything with fire, he's like, okay, give it to me. So be careful, don't burn yourselves. But speaking about writing a song for a special evening in a special place, a few years ago, as Tracy and I were looking to spend more time here, we had these crazy dreams of of making some sort of creative space out here, a retreat center, some sort of studio, some place where, well, it's really just selfish. I just wanted to get out here and write songs and drink this in and also share it with other people. So this song came to me when I was kind of scheming and dreaming, and on a trip back from Crestone, we had stayed at an Airbnb down the road and hooked up with some friends, and we're telling them of our dreams, and I actually, my friend Tamara's here tonight. I can't see you because it's pitch black out there, but I dedicate this to you because you helped me dream a little bit. You helped me scheme a little bit, and wherever you are, my friend, I'm sending out love to you right now. I know I'll probably see you after the show. But this is a song I would like to dedicate to all of you, Crestone, okay? And I need to teach a little part to it, okay? When I sing this line, I'm gonna go like this. Way down in Crestone. When I sing that, you're gonna go like this. Crestone, this is your part. La da da da. Down in Crestone. La da da da. Down in Crestone. La da da da. I hear you singing. Crestone. Down in Crestone. All right, I can hear you. I know some of you know how to throw some harmonies in there, too. Keep that in your memory banks, all right? Because I'm going to need you on the chorus of this song. Boy, you're crazy.
These ideas in your head. Who you been talking to, listening to, that fills you with them. From the outside, looks like you got it all. Life of music, family, little money, and a house on the hill. You see some signs point you down the road to some desert mountain home. Some crazy dream keeps calling you back. Boy, you wanna risk all of that. Down in Crestone. La da da da. Down in Crestone. La da da da.
All right, let's put up those lights, everybody. Come on. Come on. Got them, light them up, come on. I mean the lighters, that is, come on. I know this is Crestone, yeah. So this next verse, when I was a young seminary and I would ride a mountain bike up to the stupa, and I'd always stop by at this little mine on the way back. And I thought it was just cool that there was just this mine shaft sitting in the side of the hill. And then later when I was touring some spaces out here with my friend Tamara, my friend Nat, we were walking through the Shumei Center, and I was walking over this little, well, it was like a pond, and it was a little river running through it. And as I almost stepped to the last step, I felt this huge rush of energy down in Crestone. Down in Crestone. And I looked over past that little river and I said, there's a mine shaft. They built this beautiful place right around that mine shaft that I used to gaze into down in Crestone. Da 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 da. Down in Crestone. Da 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 da. And this is the verse I wrote. Miners will mine.
Always search for that golden vein. After they find it, they mine it, and they hock it, go looking for more of the same. conventional wisdom will tell you just stay put. But you seem to keep walking in the dark caves, my brother. Can you see your own foot right out there in front of you? You say these dreams keep calling you back. I wonder if there's something you lack. You see the signs point you down the road to some desert mountain home down in Crestone. Down in Crestone. Brother, if you've seen them, all those stars in that pristine desert sky, apart from the traffic, the noise, the confusion of these city lights. Well, I'm well aware this could be a midlife crisis for me, but I don't want no Porsche, no Audi, no young girlfriend. Just wanna make me my desert monastery, because these dreams won't leave me alone. Keep on asking if I'm the one. Keep seeing signs pointing me down the road. Take a plunge into the unknown. Down in Crestone, da, 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 da. 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 Da, da. Some crazy dreams keep calling me back. Keep on asking if I'm the one down in Crestone.
One big la da da da. La da da. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for listening to my songs inspired by this amazing place, this amazing town, this sky. And right now, we are going to get a little tour of the night sky. We're going to strike these lights. We're gonna get Professor Burns out here in just a moment. So if my helpers can help me set up the projector and all that stuff, and we'll be back with our tour of the night sky. And how's your night going, by the way, everybody? Is it amazing to be together? Did you ever think this would happen again? Well, it has, and it has tonight, because we are celebrating. That's right. All righty. So give us just a few moments to get our tour of the night skies on over here. And I know we got some telescopes set up for a little bit later. Thank you. All right, well, they're getting set up. Me and Jeffy are going to sneak in one more for you right here. Something I love about this night sky here. Oh, you can turn Jeffy back on if you want, Benjamin. Something I love about this night sky is it just calls you to just breathe, to just take a moment and just be present. Jeffy, would you mind starting us off here? Here it is, it's 1:15. I've been here for hours, I'm still not eating again. Just some coffee and some sweets and a little caffeine to kickstart me back into the scene. I got no regrets for this life I created. But a million miles an hour, every day has got me faded and I'm feeling the spin. Got the shakes again, somebody ordered me a drink, but to crash again, singing. Just breathe, just breathe, just breathe now. Just breathe, just breathe, just breathe now. Just breathe, just breathe, just breathe now. Just breathe, just breathe now. Just breathe, just breathe, just breathe now. Just breathe, just breathe, just breathe now. Ah, so we're all breathing here tonight. About to take in this night sky. Is that thing set up and all ready to go? Just breathe, just breathe now. Just breathe, just breathe, breathe now. Just breathe, just breathe, breathe now. Thanks, Jeffy Stasny. Appreciate you all. All righty, ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment we've been waiting for. Our hearts have been opened, and now our minds are going to be blown. Oh, the art, yes. Oh, my gosh. Thank you, Scott Carlson. Thank you so much. We have a drawing, three drawings. All right, let's welcome Scott to the stage. Come on up here, my friend. Yeah, okay, what's our, if you enter the drawing, what's the first thing we're giving away? Two children's books, Starry Eye by Denise Devon. Thanks, Denise, for donating these. Our first winner. Oh, there's one.
In a second, we'll
get to that. All right, first winner. Yeah, no favorites. We are ready.
You probably can't hear me. Oh, here we go.
All right, Brad. Brad Garone, are you here?
Oh, Brad.
Brad's not here. Are we keeping going? Okay, we'll email him. All right, there we go. Okay. He left his email on there.
Okay.
We're getting email.
Okay, is this the second book? All right. Cynthia Benson? Boyson? Cynthia?
Cynthia.
Okay. We'll email her too.
Okay.
All right. What's our third drawing? Ah, year membership to, is this the Hooper Pool one or is this? Ah, it's a big one right here. Right, right. Okay, family of four. So who gets this? Who gets this lovely gift? Oh, please be here. Please, God. Aurora. Does that mean? All right. All right. Aurora, you got it. Aurora Pesquiera. Yes. All righty. I think she's here. Let's give her a hand, everybody. All righty. So did you guys know? Okay, those are our drawings tonight. And did you guys know also, here, I'll give you that to you, Scott. Thank you, Scott. Hey, did you guys hear there's a street festival tomorrow? You've heard the buzz around town about that? So many great things happening tomorrow. Benjamin, would you like to just come up and give a couple thanks before we introduce the professor here? All right, Benjamin Beyer, everybody.
Okay.
Hello, everybody. Thank you guys for coming out tonight. This is nice, nice night and nice crowd. Tonight is a special night because we've worked probably years since we've started the Dark Sky Initiative. Kairina has really put endless hours into this, endless hours. So let's hear it for Kairina, our mayor, Crestone, Colorado. Come on, one more time.